What's up, guys? Nerdy Newb here. Welcome to a new unboxing video. I'm pretty excited about this, although I don't know if you guys are gonna be excited about this. A lot of you guys have asked me to unbox this on my channel, but probably not this version of it. So in this video, we're gonna be unboxing the 2017 June Owl Crate Junior. So this is the Owl Crate Junior box. This is, for those of you who don't know, Owl Crate is a subscription box that kind of is more geared towards books. A lot of you guys have asked me to get an Owl Crate subscription. This is the actual junior version, so this is for kids. I think it's geared for kids ages 8 to 12-ish. That's basically kind of what they're going for. So I've never really received an Owl Crate. I've also never really watched an unboxing video for an Owl Crate. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not the biggest fan of reading. The one series that I read all the way through was Harry Potter. That was the one thing I was obsessed with. And I've read books here and there and whatnot, like autobiographies. It's really weird. I don't know why. But I'm pretty excited about this box. Because it's a new box, I'll give you some pricing details, some quick pricing details. Well, you know, as quick as I can give them. This box has three different plans that you can buy. The first one is the month-to-month, so if you just get the month-to-month subscription, it costs $27.99 per month plus $6.99 shipping. So this box comes out to be $34.98, so we'll say $35 a month. If you get the three-month plan where you pay up front, it's $26.99 per box plus the $6.99 shipping. So it's $34. Okay, it's $1. It's $34 a box, which means you have to pay $101.94 up front, so $102. If you get the 6 month plan, it's $25.99 a box plus the $6.99 shipping, so the box equals about $33, and you have to pay $197.88 up front. I will go ahead and put all the pricing details down below, and I'll also link their website if you're interested. This company actually hooked me up with a little like code thing. Some companies do that. If you use the code NOOB15 right here, that'll give you 15% off your first month of your subscription. So feel free to use that if you are interested in getting this box. All right, let's do this. Once you cut the tape and you open up the box, this is what you're gonna see. This box is super heavy. I don't know what the theme is. Here's a little book, or a little card. I think this might be a spoiler, so I'm not gonna look at it. All right, they give us, I'm actually really excited because I thought this was just a book subscription, but I see puzzles and I love puzzles, so I'm very excited right now. Yes, this might be good. I'm excited. Okay, the first item we have are puzzle erasers. So these are erasers, but they're little puzzles. I love things like this. I love little puzzles. You guys saw my haul video that I just did recently, and I got a wooden puzzle. So I'm excited for this because it makes a little bit more sense to have eraser puzzles on my desk since they're erasers and I could use them. All right, the next item we have is called Plus Plus. This is a set of 50 pieces. I don't know if you can see these. They're little, like, plus signs, but you can put them together and build things. I'm not the best builder when it comes to free building. I really like instructions because I'm not as creative, or I get frustrated really easy. In the picture, they made a little man, which I feel like if I got really good at this, I could maybe do that from scratch, but I also, I don't know. So, but this is really cool. I'm excited to try to build some stuff with this and see what I can get going. The man looks pretty hard. These were made in Denmark. That's cool. Oh, I haven't seen one of these in a while. We got a nano bug or a hex bug. This is from the Nano Habitat set. And nano bugs are just little, like, bugs that are electronic or, electronic. This one looks like a giant centipede. I don't know if you can see it in there. It probably just walks around and whatnot. It does come with the battery, so that's cool. We got this pen, and it's a puzzle pen. What? I don't, oh, yes. Okay, sorry, I got distracted. So if you can see it, you see those two, those bead balls? This is a puzzle pen, so you actually, I'm assuming you're trying to get the, well, I don't know where you're trying to get the balls to go. Probably downwards, I can imagine. Okay, this is like a perplexus, but it's like of a pen, which is probably my weakness because I love things like this. Got it! Come on. Come on. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. I got one down there. I don't even know if I'm supposed to make it go down or up, but okay, so that's really cool. We got a set of Gizmos and Gear stickers. I'm assuming this is actually connected with the, actually, I don't know. I have no idea. I was going to say with one of the books, but I don't really know. These are fancy stickers. All right. So I'm assuming that this, I don't actually know what this thing is supposed to come with, but I guess it comes with stuff and then one book. So here's a little button that it came with, this little owl button. This is a cute little button. Not like the cheap buttons that we get from all the other companies. So the book that we got this month is this. This is a real nice book. It's a hardcover book, and it's called York. And it's by Laura Ruby. Book one, The Shadow Cipher. Okay. And then it has this on the back. I don't know if it's like an autograph or if it's just a copy of an autograph. It has a letter that comes with it. I'm pretty intrigued by how nice this book is. So I think this might be Laura Ruby's autograph. And then I'm pretty sure, so I think this is an actual autograph. I think this was a letter that she wrote and they just made copies of it. So it says, Dear Owl Crate, I just realized yesterday, literally yesterday, that I am not good at cursive and I should probably practice, and I don't know why I'm not better at it than I am. So let me see if I can read this. Dear Owl Crate Junior subscriber, I am so happy to introduce my new novel, York, The Shadow Cipher. This book has all the things I like best. Kittens, robots, history, and mystery. Okay. Kittens, robots, history, and mystery sounds totally up my alley. I'm so excited right now. Brainy heroes and butt-kicking heroines. Monsters and villains are rolled up into one grand adventure. I hope you love reading it as much as I loved writing it. Best wishes, Laura Ruby. Okay, first of all, I'm pretty proud of myself for being able to read the cursive writing. That's the first step. It also came with this bookmark. Oh, I don't know. Oh, okay, wait. I don't know. There's an answer key on the back. So there's a bookmark and an answer key. Won't show that. Oh, it's not a bookmark. I'm sorry. It's a door hanger. Gosh. So here's the book. This is a pretty fat book. It's priced at $17.99 US. It's, like I said, it's a hardcover book. I really like the quality of the book. And it's one of those cool books that has the pages. I forgot what you guys called this. You guys called it something. But the pages are not straight. They're like, they look like they were like torn and then put in the book. I love that. Let me kind of show you the size of the writing. It's actually not too bad. The book itself, I can imagine as a kid, it's a little bit overwhelming when you get a book that's kind of thick. But my test is when I open it, if the writing's like not super teeny tiny, then I don't mind it. I'm actually a little bit excited to start reading this book just to see if I like it. Okay, so let's see. I think that's everything in the box. There's one more card in here. It's the July theme is going to be magical creatures, which is very exciting. So let's go through some pricing recap. And before I do that, I just want to say that I'm not going to lie. $35 for this box before I opened it was really expensive to me. In my mind, I was like, oh, that's expensive for a box that's going to have a book. But this box is like really good in quality. And I know you might not be able to see that by looking at it through my video, but the box is really nice. The items are really nice. They were packaged really nice. It's just, this is a very thoughtful box. So I don't know if it's going to hit its price point or not. I just wanted to point out that the box itself is very nice in quality and just thoughtfulness, I feel like. Okay, so here's a card, and then I'm pretty sure this is where it has the thing. So let's go ahead and do some pricing recap. So here's the recap. The theme this month was Gizmos and Gears. So that's where that sticker sheet, I'm assuming, came into play. So let me grab my calculator. All right, here we go. The first item we had was our York book. Okay, I thought, trying to be really smooth and that didn't work. I really like this book. You can get this book right now on Amazon for $11. So I'm gonna go ahead and price this at $11. It is a really nice book. I can't recommend it yet because I don't know if it's good or not. I didn't read it, but $11 for that. I would probably give these plus plus puzzle things, it's 50 piece. I'd probably give that about $5. I would say $5 is pretty good. You can get them for a little bit more when there's like 70 pieces or 100 pieces, about $10. So we'll say $5 for that. Our puzzling erasers. I would say that this would be something you could get from the dollar store, but I don't actually think it is. I think this is something a little bit nicer than that. Something that you'd find at one of those, not the boutique shops, but things not at the dollar store. So I'd probably give this anywhere from like $4 to $5, maybe I think $6 is pushing it. Let's give it $5. I'd pay $5 for that. Hexbug Nano Habitat Set. I would probably give this anywhere. I'd probably give this like $6 or $7. I don't know exactly what these go for. 7 seems a little bit high, but I also know, I think at Target these are $10. So let's go ahead and give it 7. And then we had our sticker sheet. I'm going to go ahead and give that $1. And we had this little button. I usually don't price out buttons, but this is actually, like, this button you could actually use. It's not like it says a theme or anything like that. It actually does. So it does say a theme, but they put it on the edge, so you can't really see it. So if you were to put this on your backpack, you wouldn't be just a walking billboard for them. I'll go ahead and give that $1. It's a cool little owl. This bookmark that goes with the book, I'd probably just give that 50 cents. And then, technically, I think this book technically came with the author's autograph right here. I don't know what this is worth, and I think it's on a sticker. I'd probably just give this an extra few dollars to make the book a little bit more worth it. It would have been nicer if she signed the book, obviously. But I'd probably give that maybe like $2 extra, so you make the book worth about $13 with that. All right, so that is all the items in the book. This box came out to be $31.50. Now, pricing-wise, I think I priced things pretty spot on. I forgot the pen. I'm sorry. I would give this pen $2. I love that pen, actually. So $33.50. This box cost $35 if you get the month-to-month plan. So we were a little bit short on the value. Now, pricing-wise, you might be able to give another dollar to this potentially and make it $8. I don't really know. Maybe you could potentially give it $2 more. At most. I kind of made my guesses on this based off of pricing because then I didn't find anything for the 50 piece, so it was hard to find. You might be able to add in $1 more to that. So I think based off my pricing, this box was a couple dollars short. You know, I price things low and a little bit weird, so you could potentially add a couple more dollars, give or take. Even if you were to, though, you would basically only be getting your value for this box. So that's one of the things that you just have to keep in mind. So technically, based off my pricing, this box did not hit its value by $1.50. Which, again, I think you could make up if you were to add a couple dollars here and there to things that I kind of undervalued or underpriced. All right, here's my thoughts on the box. First of all, like I said before I priced it, because I wanted to say that prior to knowing how much this box was worth, this box is really nice. The quality of this box is really nice. That is one thing I'm going to say. It doesn't seem like they just threw the box together whatsoever. It's well built, and just you can tell just the quality of their postcards and just the things that they included. It's good stuff. Now, unfortunately, I don't think that this box gets a ton of extra value, and in theory, we should be getting about $10 extra value. And I want to say the reasoning for that is the book. The book is priced at $17.99, but you can get it on Amazon for $11. And that's one of the tricky things with books is that the MSRP for the book is really high always, but you can always get the book way cheaper, whether you even go to the bookstores or if you go online. And that is one thing to keep in mind. I mean, if you were to have priced the book at $18, you could have added another $6 to this, and then there's a few things that I undervalued and whatnot. So I would say that this is just like a kid's box. I wouldn't expect to get about $10 extra value for a $35 box like I would normally for like a geek subscription box. I would want at least $5, and we didn't get that in this box, so that's a little bit disappointing. I would be interested. I don't know. I think I need to go watch videos for the regular owl crate, not the kid owl crate. I always thought that this box just came with books, but I like how they give other things. And I actually really like this junior box. I'm not going to lie, because this stuff applies to me and my work. So it's not like stuff that I don't have any use for. I definitely have use for all of the additional items. And the book is really nice. I'm actually excited to kind of read the book. I don't know where I fall in regards to categories, because I think they also have a young adult box, so it's like adult, young adult, and youth or junior, and I feel like I would have to see. I feel like I connect really well with the junior box, but I wouldn't mind testing out the regular owl crate, because I know a lot of you guys have asked about it, and obviously you guys aren't as kid-ish as I am sometimes, so probably the adult box would apply to you a little bit more. If I had to rate this box, so here's the thing. Usually a box doesn't get above a 3 if it doesn't hit its value, in theory. But because this box is so well put together, I would definitely give it at least a 3. I would probably say 3.5 out of 5 noobs. I want to give it more. I really do. It's just hard because it's lacking in value. I think that this box needs one more item, maybe a smaller book. I don't know how it works. I don't know if they only give one book, if that's their niche. But I think that they need just a little bit more value just to make this box worth it, or else you'd be better off just going and buying individual products. Now, as with any subscription box, the cool thing about this box when it comes to like, oh, you can just go buy the products, is I didn't know a lot of these products existed. So one of the cool things about it is that it kind of introduces you to things that you might not have known about, like those plus plus puzzle put together build kit. I had no idea that it was such a big thing. I started looking at it. I was like, wow, this is like actually a thing. So that is one of the cool things about boxes like these, is it showcases items that you might not have ever known about. And then afterwards, yeah, you probably could just go online and buy those products for the same amount of money, but you would have never known about it if you didn't get the box. So that probably gives it a little bit more value to the box itself. But I would say I'm comfortable with the 3.5 out of 5 noobs. If this box had hit its value, just at least hit its value, I probably would give it a 3.75 to a 4. If it would have gotten extra value, it probably would have been a 4.5 out of 5 noobs. At this point, if you liked everything in the box, I don't think you could give it any more than a 4. I think it just is lacking a little bit in value. That's my take on it. I'm kind of excited. I might go on their website and see their other options, like the young adult and the adult box, just because I'm kind of interested and intrigued now to see what kind of stuff they give. Again, it caught me off guard because I thought it was only a box of books, but it's not. All right, there you have it. The Owl Crate Junior Box. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, feel free to click the like button below. If you want to see more unboxing videos, go check out my channel. I have a whole bunch on there. And you should subscribe. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys thought about this box. Does anyone get either the Owl Crate, the Young Adult Owl Crate, or the Owl Crate Junior? Let me know what your thoughts are and, you know, what your take on the value is. Again, there's some boxes sometimes that just aren't necessarily out there to make a ton of extra value or to give you a ton of extra value. It's more of a showcase. You know, for boxes like this, it's the whole point is for the young readers out there to keep them engaged and intrigued with new books and new ideas and new things. So I do enjoy that sense of the box, and because of that, it makes me, you know, interested in potentially getting this box again. I like the concept of the box, and I'm a fan of that. But yeah, let me know what you thought about it down below. And remember, if you subscribe to my channel and your subscriptions aren't blocked or sent to private, you'll make it onto my Thank You to Subscribers page, which is coming up shortly. Also, let's go ahead and do the video shout out. Today's video shout out goes to Phantom R1 Aughts. Oh, Riot. Phantom Riot. Oh, that was embarrassing. Phantom Riot, thank you so much for watching and commenting on my videos. I appreciate all of your support. And you get the video shout out. I'm so embarrassed that I said R1 Aught. Like, that doesn't even make any sense. Oh, gosh. All right, guys, I hope you have an amazing day, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.